I'd made the promise to clean up. I didn't. Cameron was approaching his second birthday.
Shawn had fallen asleep on the couch. It was, you know, a soma-induced sleep with our son on the couch. And our son was just climbing all over him and saying, "Daddy's asleep."
You know, it was just the realization that now he was getting old enough to see, you know, I was running out of time.
He stumbled into Cameron's room to read the bedtime story. And it was, I think, the saddest thing I'd ever seen. He was trying so hard to be a good dad, and he was still struggling with himself.
It just became very apparent to me that if I wasn't careful, I was going to ruin him. And that wasn't anything he asked for.
Shawn woke up in the middle of the night and he said, "Where are all the cookies?" And I said, "Baby, you ate them. You and Cameron ate them." And he didn't remember. And for some reason, that did it for him.
You can combine a lot of stuff in one night. And then a phone call with Kevin Nash where he was just saying, "Man, you got to stop doing, you know, you've been doing that stuff anymore, man." Then went on to talk about Hunter and I hadn't talked in a year. Kevin, you know, being a buddy, saying, "That's your fault, too." You know, and convincing me that it was, and you need to call him. I mean, I woke up the next day and was like, I just felt different.
He told me that he was never taking pills or drinking again. And from that point, he didn't, you know, so that was the turning point for him.